I wonder, what you both make of decision advantage today against potential adversaries such as Russia, China, others out there in the world. And what would decision advantage really have to look like in the future as the battlefield becomes more complex?
Sure, I think that's a great question. I would say, everyone's thinking about this. China recently announced their own JADC2 competitor. Its decision advantage is sort of one of these really eminent issues across the board for everyone. I think at the present moment, if I were pressed, I would say I mean, we definitely have a kind of decision advantage at the moment, but it all depends on context. Russia and China both have very hierarchical decision-making structures and comparatively less intelligence to work with. We're seeing that laid bare for Russia right now in Ukraine. And there's evidence to suggest that China has similar issues, particularly in the difficulty of their different wings of their armed forces to collaborate and communicate due to that hierarchical structure. But the fact is, both China and Russia recognize the decision advantage we currently have and what we're trying to build. So both of them have sort of specific military documents that really call this out and aim to engage, would only aim to engage American forces where they can minimize or diminish our decision advantage. That would be limited, localized conflicts. I think a decision advantage that we should be aiming for is one that's resilient, one that's able to take those attacks that they're trying to build out for systems like Project Overmatch and is able to kind of maintain situation advan sorry, decision advantage when elements of our systems may be compromised.
Certainly. And Brian, how about you?
Yeah, Megan, to build on that, I think those are great points. So if you think of decision advantage as being able to make faster and better decisions than your opponent, then there's some things that sort of fall out of that in terms of, well, technologically, what do I need? Operationally, what do I need? One way of looking at that is, if I can make decisions at a scale and a tempo that sort of overwhelms my opponent, well, then I can certainly, maybe constrain his options and start to drive him into a position where he has to seek an off-ramp. And a way to do that is to have, connectivity with more of the force, have a larger number of potential units you can draw upon. It's not every sensor, every shooter, but it's being able to communicate with, more of the force and then have a more disaggregated force. So you've got more tools to play with and recompose in new ways.